Hello world, welcome to my channel. I am Sahil and you are learning Vue.js beginner's course from the scratch, and this is the sixth video of this series. And in this video I am going to show you about filters in Vue.js. So why filters are used in Vue.js? Filters are used to apply common text formatting, and we can use filter directly in a string interpolation method. So let's start coding to understand in better way. So this is our index.html file with basic setup for Vue.js, and this is main.js file. Okay, so let's first create a filter for changing lowercase letters to uppercase. You can create filters in two ways, either locally inside the Vue instance or globally outside of the Vue instance. We can use local filters only in the selected DOM, whereas in global we can use in the whole project. Okay, so let's first create a local one. Okay, so like data property or computed property, we will use filters property of Vue.js to create local filters. Okay, so here write filters, then inside this we will create our local filters. So here I'm creating a filter for changing lowercase letters to uppercase. So here I am just writing the name of the filter uppercase, and it's just like a function or method. So it contains parentheses, and we have to pass a parameter value in the parentheses and then return value dot to uppercase. Now by default Vue.js does not have inbuilt filters. We have to create our own filters using native JavaScript functions. So this to uppercase is a native JavaScript function. Okay, so using native JavaScript function we can create our filters in Vue.js. Okay, so now let's see how to use these filters in our DOM. So for using, let's first create a data property object. So here I'm creating a message, and here I'm writing hello world. So here you can see I have written this message in a small letters. Okay, so just save this and go to the index.html. here just write h1 tag, and first I am just displaying the message. So here write the message, go to the browser, refresh. So here you can see the message is displaying in a small case. Okay, now small case or lowercase. Okay, now here if we want to apply the uppercase filter here, so for this how to apply, so just use this pipe symbol and then write the name of the filter. So our filter is uppercase. Now save this, go to the browser, refresh. So here you can see the text has been changed to the uppercase. Okay, so this way the filters work. Now again go to the index.html. now here in main.js this is a local filters. Now how to create a global filter? So for creating global filter, just above this Vue instance we will use this Vue object to create a global filters. Okay, so just write Vue dot and call a method filters. Now inside this we have to write the name of the filter. So I will just use this same, and this is the name of the filter, and this filter contains a function. So just write the function, and in function parentheses we have to use a parameter. So just write value. Now here we have to just write the same thing that we have written here. So just copy this and paste here. Okay, now just delete it from here, save this. Now this is a global filter. Okay, and we can use same like we have used in previous. Okay, so just save this, go to the browser, refresh. So here you can see the same message is displaying as in uppercase. Okay, now again let's create another filter. Now this time I am going to create a filter to change the first letter to capital letter only, and the rest ones will be the same. Okay, so for this let's create a filter capitalize. Okay, now here give a parameter value. Now here use return. Now value dot caret. Now this is a array function of JavaScript that will targets only the first index of the array. That is here you can see I have given a zero index number. That's why it only select this first array element. Okay, you all know very well that array start from the zero index. Okay, so we are targeting this first element of the array, and it this only will be converted to uppercase, and rest all are the will be same. Okay, so now here we will use the two uppercase function, and then the rest for the rest of the string we will use plus sign for concatenation, and again we will call the value, and we will use a function slice. Now what this slice does, it will print the rest of the string as it is, that is mentioned in the message variable, because we have passed here one, that is it is denoting this denoting from this e. Okay, now whatever the string comes after this h, then it will print same like this. Okay, because we have we did not use uppercase here, we have just used uppercase for the first letter only. Okay, so now just save this and just copy the capitalize filter, and here we can just use the capitalize. Go to the browser, refresh. Here you can see the first letter is uppercase and the rest are in lowercase. Okay, so this is how you can use another filter. Now let's create one more filter for counting the number of letters that is used in a string. Okay, so for this let's create a filter count letters. Okay, now in parentheses write the value parameter, and here return value dot length. Okay, now just use this filter to count the number of letters that is used to create the string. So let's paste here, save, go to the browser. Here you can see 11. Okay, now this hello world have total 11 characters, and this is counting through this filter. Okay, so now let's create a input field, input type text, and here write the b dash model directive, and here pass message, and you can write here number of characters. Okay, now go to the browser, refresh. So here you can see the hello world is written here, and it's showing 11, number of character is 11. Now when I just delete this, then you can see the number of character is 0. Now when I am writing something, then you can see the it countings reactively the number of characters that we have written in the input field. Okay, so this is so cool. You can see when I am deleting, then you can see the number of character is decreasing here. And if you write something, then the number of characters is counting and displaying here. So now let's go to the main.js and create another filter. And now this filter will convert the object variables in JSON format. So for converting the object variables value in JSON format, we have to create a filter. But before creating the filter, let's define the data here. So for this, let's create a user object, and now inside this user we are creating another object like username, and here I'm writing some values, wolfmania email, like wolfmania@gmail.com. And sorry, we have to write in single quote or double quote. And you can write country India. Okay, now let's create the filter. So here you can create globally also or local also. So let's create global filter. So here use view object filter. Now in parentheses write the name of the filter. So I'm just writing JSON, and it contains function. So function, and here write value. Okay, now here just use return JSON dot stringify, and then pass the value here. Okay, now this is a native JavaScript function to convert object variable values in JSON format. Okay, so let's use this function in our DOM. Sorry, this filter in our DOM. So for this, we have to go in index.html, and just here I'm creating a paragraph tag, and here just user. User. Now again use the pipe symbol and JSON, write the filter JSON. Okay, now go to the page and refresh. So here you can see the object variables values has been changed into JSON format. Okay, so like this you can change to the JSON format, and it will be helpful when we are working on a project and want to send a JSON format data to the server. Okay, so this will become very useful there. So let's see another filters. Now I will create a filter that will check the minimum numbers in an array. It means it will pick a minimum value number from an array. Okay, so for this let's create a filter. You can either create locally or globally. So let's create globally. So view filter, and here I will use min the name of the filter, and here write function, and it will contain value parameter. And now here we have to write like return math dot min function. Okay, now it min, write 3 dot, and then pass value. Okay, now we have to create a array. So for this let's create a array. So I will here creating numbers, so nos, and for creating array let's use this big bracket, and inside this write some numbers like 100 400. So as you can see here, the smallest number is 75. So we want to pick a smallest number using this filter. So how to pick a smallest number using this filter, let's see. So here in index.html, let's create another h1 tag, and here let's write the nos data object, and here use the pipe symbol, and then you can pass the min filter. Okay, now go to the browser, and here you can see the 75 is showing. Okay, so this filter is also working fine. Now if you want to show the maximum value from the array, so for this you just have to change here max from max to min to max, and here write max and leave all the same, and you just have to change min to max here. Just go to the browser. So here you can see the 400 is the largest number in the array. You can see here also the 400 is the largest number in the array. Okay, so it's also working fine. Now I will create the last filter for repeating a string value. So for this, let's create a filter repeat text. Okay, so here I will just using repeat text, and here pass two parameter, string and number of times. So here I'm just writing times, and write return string dot repeat. Repeat is a native JavaScript functions, and here I will use times. Okay, now how to use this? Now if I want to print this India 4 times, okay, so for this what we have to do is, let's save this and copy, go to index.html, and here in another h1 tag, first user dot country for displaying the country India, and then I will use this pipe symbol, and then here use this repeat text. Now we have passed a parameter there, number of times. So here how many times we want to repeat this text. So here you can use any numbers like 4, 5, 45, 50, any numbers. Okay, so I will use 4 times, and then save this, go to the browser. So refresh. So here you can see here India printed 4 times. Okay, so here just give a space here and save, go to the browser. So here you can see India is printed 4 times here. If you change the number here like 10 and save, then here you can see the India is printed 10 times. Okay, so this is how filters work in Vue.js. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, then hit on like button, and please subscribe my channel.